Hey everyone, Ed Friedland, the Bass Whisperer here, special quarantine edition. We've let all the standards go. I don't wear long pants anymore. I don't wear sleeves. Screw it. I got this thing in the mail. Where is it? Awesome little thing called the Nino Mute. Now you may remember a little while back I showed you the Nordy Mute. It's exactly the same concept, but it's tailored for upright bass. Nino is a fellow that works with Carrie Nordstrand, the inventor of the Nordy Mute. And I'm sure at some point he said, hey, why not for upright bass? And we're glad you thought of that because it's a really cool little thing. Now, there are mutes for upright basses that exist. These big rubber things, and they clamp onto the bridge itself, and it's the idea is to mute the bridge and mute the sound of the bass. It's so ARCO players, like if you want to practice quietly in your apartment, say, and not disturb your neighbor, or there are even some orchestral works that have segments where, you know, they tell you to put the mute on the bass because it gives the instrument a very ghostly, distant sound. So whatever, I mean, mutes exist for the upright bass, but they don't do what this does. Much like the Nordy Mute, it essentially just thumps up the sound of the bass, and that's something I like very much. So here's the bass. It's my Christopher Plywood with a Tomastic Spiracore Vikes. Beautiful string. I love it. They have a, you know, that clarity, the growl, the sustain. Listen to the sustain. I mean, I love the way that sounds. It's perfect for modern jazz. Guess what, newsflash, I don't play modern jazz like maybe once a year I get to do something like that. What happens is if I take this bass out on a gig, let's say I'm playing like older style jazz, let's say I'm playing country or honky tonk or rockabilly or any kind of a rootsier style of playing, let's say I'm swing jazz, Django-y kind of stuff, you know. The problem with this great tone that you get is a wow, 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 wow. I mean, it's very hard to cut the sustain of the note because that's what these strings do. And if I mean, you can shorten it at the left hand by like releasing sooner, maybe not pushing down quite all the way. Sometimes, you know, when I'm playing, you know, just throw a lot of extra meat on the string, that deadens it a little bit. But the Nino Mute, where are you? Here he is. The Nino Mute, this thing does it right away. So check it out. You pop it in there and you know, for me, that's a tone that I can use in my work life. I'm playing more rootsy stuff. You know, it sounds good, but what I have found in these period styles, you know, older styles, where the bass didn't have the Ron Carter growl and sustain, if you approach that music with a modern setup on your bass, to me it just sounds wrong. You don't get the attack, you don't get the thump, all of that, it gets in the way because you're supposed to provide that boom and be gone. That's that style of music. And so for me to be able to just pop this thing onto my jazz axe so that I would consider this, it's a wonderful thing. To my ears, it makes the instrument sound a little more Paul Chambers-ish. For example, without the mute, it's still, you know, it's sort of like his style, but It's got too much of the rrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr Okay, and we got. I love that. Now, I've also heard that this is very effective through an amplifier. I haven't really tried it yet, so let's check it out. All right, I've plugged it into the amp. I've got a David Gage Lifeline pickup going into, where is it? My little PJB, the bass cub on top of the, I think it's the BG150, little tiny powered cabinet. These are 5-inch speakers. This is a great little upright rig. I use this on gigs. It covers it, and it's a good tone. So anyway, here's the sound of the bass, again, without the Nino mute. That's all that Ron Carter shit, which these strings is like, I love that. But, you know, I can't make any money playing that way. That's just me. Some people can. Ron Carter made a lot of money playing that way, but nobody wants to pay me to do that. However, but they do pay me to sound like this. You know, it's so nice to get that tone without having to alter my technique. I can just play straight ahead and boom, it sounds right on this bass. So that's a wonderful thing. So now when you play like funky kind of R&B stuff, it's really good for that too. So here's without it. Now, without it, that's a great sound, you know, reminds me again, Ron Carter, all those CTI 70s kind of rock fusion jazz stuff where they had him playing upright. Wonderful sound. I just, you know, I love that. But again, with the mute, you get a whole different kind of a vibe with that. It's, dare I say, funkier. The nice thing about this mute is that it leaves enough of the note remaining so that it's actually useful in the full range of the instrument. You know how sometimes when you mute your electric bass with some foam or whatever, and then you start playing above the 12th fret and it sounds horrible because there's nothing left. There's no string vibration almost to produce a note. And so they don't sound very good up there. But this thing, it leaves enough of the note so that it sounds good through the whole range. Clear up there. So, you know, I mean, those notes are actually still useful up there. So that's a wonderful thing. This is a cool little thing. I don't know what they cost. He just sent it to me because I'm the Bass Whisperer, and so I didn't have to pay for it. Suckers. I can't be much. And honestly, you know, for upright players, there's nothing like this out there. You may have thought of trying something like this on your own. I have. I've muted strings with all sorts of stuff. It doesn't really work that well, does it? But this, pretty uniform. Nice response. Check it out. Nino Mute, y'all.